All right, welcome back from that commercial break. You're still watching Saloon Talk. I'm your girl, Savaria Hughes. Hey, people, before we went for the commercial break, this whole episode has just been amazing for me because I grew up seeing him. I grew up seeing him creating designs in minutes, and now I have the chance to ask him how, because trust me, no matter the child of the richest man in the world, sometimes what are not talents, but you don't have the talent, you cannot force it. So Latif, before I went for the commercial break, I was gonna ask you the question of your inspiration, but besides your inspiration, I want to know that talent of creating a dress. I've seen your YouTube videos. I have seen very many of them on you on stage, and you're creating a design and an outfit in less than, what is the longest time that you have taken on stage while creating an outfit?
Thank you so much. First of all, people must know that I am his uniqueness, and that's what I call myself. And to me, I believe that every person has an element of uniqueness in them. So once you discover yourself, whatever you discover in yourself, that's the uniqueness. Chechenja urocho ina mugwe. So I always wanted to be different. I always wanted to be unique, you know. When you asked me about the inspiration, like I told you, I used to watch Lucky Dube. I used to listen to a lot of Lucky Dube music, and of course Michael Jackson. But what was very fascinating about their music was their performances. I used to admire their stage performances and how Lucky Dube would sing exactly like the same way you hear the music on the tape or on the CD. So I was like, I'm not a musician. How can I do fashion the same way? How can I pull a crowd, you know, on stage? It really used to bother me a lot. And this is how I started, you know. But like I told you, it comes with a lot of considerations, because there are many things that you must consider. First of all, you must have done fashion for some good time, because it takes a lot of geometry, statistics, arithmetics, basically
also
art and mathematics.
Arithmetics.
Yeah, wow. It's not the subsidiary math. It's not the applied. There's another kind of math, but this is basically arithmetics, pure math. But this is basically arithmetics. It's a type of art that you join together with math, basically to have arithmetics. There's a lot of calculations, you know. Also traveling really enhanced my performance or my creativity, because when you take a plane from Entebbe, let's say it takes this direction when it's taking off, but the direction is supposed to be this side. The moment it faces this side, straight to Amsterdam. So I was like, okay, in fashion we have what we call panels or patterns, and I could, you know, turn a dress of, let's say, 5-7 patterns into one pattern. So there's just too much behind that creation. Something that you may not even find in school, which it's not there in the syllabus. I'm very proud to be part of the expert team that has created the new syllabus for our, you know, learners from level 1 to level 6. But it's not there in the syllabus. So this is something that you have to use your talent, something you need to create, to basically to create identity for yourself. I didn't want to be like any other designer who make clothes in the workshop and bring them for a showcase. I always wanted to create my designs live on stage.
I think the majority, no offense to all designers out there, but I think majority of Ugandan designers are more of people, what I've known, what I've seen, Wagende Kampala, Obasanga, just they buy clothes, they come to boutique.
I know.
Munayafu said design.
But the other question that you asked me about, how long, which is the longest?
Yes, what is the longest time?
Maybe I can give you a few recognized shows that I've done, where I've performed, like in Belgium. I made 7 dresses in 27 minutes. I'm talking about 27 minutes, making 7 dresses, taking measurements from 7 models, cutting 7 fabrics and sewing 7 fabrics in 27 minutes.
I think this is why they gave you an award, because even
the Afro Fashion Magician.
My jaw is dropped, but
I first did it in Ireland, in Dublin, where I constructed a dress in 4 minutes. And it was a Nigerian MC who actually turned it into business. And he was like, who is ready to buy a dress Latif made in 4 minutes? And this is where the business came
honestly
in.
Honestly speaking, if you do a dress in that moment, someone may actually just put up the money, not because they know what you're going to do, but they are like shocked he cannot make a dress in 4 minutes.
That's
like,
right.
That's impossible. And then you create something really
amazing.
But
you must also remember that I have an award to that in Norway, where I made 10 dresses in 23 minutes. Actually, I was challenging my previous record, where I constructed 7-8 dresses in 27 minutes, but this time I was making 10 dresses in 23 minutes, which was basically 2.3 minutes per dress. Exactly. Recently, I won an award in Washington, in Washington DC, where I made 6 dresses. I think it was about 16 or 15 minutes. I won the most exceptional talented person in the globe. Making 6 dresses in 16 minutes.
If you're already as humble as you are now, what if some of us reached there? What if
I just step on everyone? I made a step, you know, to reach out to Guinness World Record, because to me this was exceptional.
Yeah, nobody has done it before.
Therefore, I've been assessed by the Guinness World Record to set a new fashion record of the most made outfits in the shortest time possible. So watch out for that.
So you have to also beat the record you set for yourself.
It's not even actually beating, it's basically setting a new fashion. It's not there. Techiba deo.
But it's already even yours, so there's no beating. Techiba
deo. So records in nyingi nyoze nina, tewali yali atungide kunyonyi. I'm the first man, you know, to ever sew with a sewing machine on the plane.
Did you have to first say hello to the company producers?
Actually, that's a very good question. Before I made that attempt, I first did it in Chicago. And when we were just waiting, we had a delay. I was traveling from Chicago to Brussels. And everybody was on their laptops, on their iPads, and I'm like, what am I doing here? I got out my suitcase, got fabrics, cut them right there, turned my suitcase the other way around, placed my sewing machine and started making 2 dresses. So the cabin crew were passing, you know, we are now starting to board, and they were like, this is amazing, what are you trying to do? They passed, but when we reached in Belgium, she was like, what were you doing? Are you a designer? Are you an artist? And I'm like, yeah. But then I asked them, can I do it on board? Then they are like, yeah, if you contact the airline, first of all. So I went, I Googled about TSA, that is Transportation Security Administration. Amateka agafuga, ebitambuzibwa ku nnyonyi, nensoma bulungi nnyo amateeka ago, nenga kuguka bulungi. What I discovered, there are certain things that you can carry on board and things that you cannot carry on board. What you can do and what you cannot do. So we namalo kuguka bulungi, this is where I made a move. Nentunga ekiteteeyi ekyasooka nga nva Seattle, nga ngenda Dubai. But the most viral one was when I was flying from Miami to California.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, I think we're going to come back to the dress. Janet! To see senor now, so first tell us, because like I said, fashion has a lot. There is the designer, the creative designer, we have Latif on the set, there is the musician himself that gives the vibe and the ambience to the thing, and then also what do you want, you know, not tamburamu, just to show you guys how beautiful the dress is. So Janet, what does it feel being a model? Leave alone, first wait working for Latif. You as a model, ngabakwambazize chintu, and they're telling you, go on stage, do this, because there's a lot of people, a big crowd. What do you feel when you're walking down the stage?
Okay, truth be told, at the first moment, you would feel nervous, you know, like stepping out and not everyone would be want to look at how the outfit would be looking. So you would kind of step back, you know, with that fear, oh my God, how will I look? You know, what if I fall, the shoes, the heels? So you'll be like, no, for real, I cannot move out. But then later on, you tend to swallow the pride and you know what? Yeah. We have to work.
They're going
to
be paying
you. Yeah, yeah, they have to pay you. So you have to showcase what you are supposed to be paid for, and then you know.
You said models are supposed to be on a meat plan. I am a model myself, but me, I'm a commercial model. So for me, I eat what I want. If it's pizza, guamani, you have to hire me the way you see me. So you said that being a runway model, mostly when you're going to do someone's project, you have to like be on a meal plan. You have to make sure that the dress fits you. So have you ever been in a moment whereby, like, if, let me say, akwada katete ingateka kutuka, and you're like, let me just swallow, not to like be abused, or like, okay, no, no, I'm not abusing you, but like, obviously, when someone has created nota mugamba, like, it doesn't fit you, there's normally a problem. So, what are some of anyway, let us first go for a short commercial break. When I come back, you're gonna answer for us as we come back to the show. Let us go for a short commercial break. Our bosses want us to make money, but when we come back, guys, the topic is still hot.